Practice set one, problem number two. Given the conversion factor, write two conversion factor fractions. Conversion factor fractions are created from conversion factors. A conversion factor is a statement of equivalence. And in problem number two, they're telling us 1 pound is equivalent or equal to 16 ounces. To write this conversion factor fraction, it's based on the property that anytime you have the same thing over the same thing, we know it to be equal to 1. For example, 5 over 5 or 5 divided by 5 equals 1. And likewise, even though they don't look the same, when I write 1 pound over 16 ounces, I have created a special one, which is a conversion factor fraction. Well, there was nothing special about putting the 1 pound on top and the 16 ounces in the denominator. I could have just as easily put 16 ounces in the numerator and the 1 pound in the denominator. This also would be equal to 1, since equal things over one another are equal to 1. They will allow us to do some converting in the next couple sections. In problem number 4, they give us an equivalent 1 gallon equal to 128 fluid ounces, and they're asking us to write conversion factor fractions for this as well. Again, there's no hard fast rule what will go in the numerator, which one of those facts. So if I start with 1 gallon in the numerator over 128 fluid ounces in the denominator, that's giving me a conversion factor fraction. Same thing over the same thing. This actually is equal to 1, but it will help us with converting later. And as I said, nothing hard fast as far as rules, what goes first. So we could put the numerator value of 128 fluid ounces this time with the 1 gallon equivalent factor in the denominator.